And I don't know if anything will go wrong necessarily. I mean, I guess it only goes wrong if you are too rigidly attached to your plan. You know, if you can adapt, then you can find a way to make everything work. This is an overhead. Bear with me here. This is an overhead of the studio space. So the main idea, and again, when you listen to the song and you read the script gives a more easier kind of chronological breakdown of what I'm talking about here. Basically, the main body of the action is going to be sort of circling the room in a way, and we're going to be sort of tracking from a central sort of point here, and just consistently kind of reaffirming or the antagonist as the center point. So it's going to have a nice kind of circular motion to it. It's the flow, the movement is something I think is going to be really important. I'd originally envisioned it being done in one take. It was a little ambitious since the scene that I'm really excited to shoot. Obviously those two environments that exist, and then the climax of the song, the climax of the video, the climax of the narrative, if you will, is this point in the bridge where Melanie and her choreography comes face to face with a mirror, like a literal reflection of herself in the studio space. And that kind of echoes a really nice part of the song that literally says, you know, you look in the mirror, you know, and there's this point in it when she kind of has to come face to face with herself and what she's doing and the mere fact of her performance. And then we're going to be doing a really cool scene where she literally smashes the crap out of the mirror. So I hope none of you are superstitious. And that's going to be really cool. So, and of course, that literally and figuratively, you know, being like a representation for like destroying her own image. So, kind of like vanquishing, I guess, if you will, the performative aspect of what she's doing. She doesn't care. She's doing it because she loves it. This is her, you know, this is her life. But at the same time, there's a sort of submission to that, you know, an acceptance of the fact that she is performing, you know. Obviously, we're pushing a lot of ideas here, but it's going to be nice and open for interpretation on the part of the viewer. It'll be a really cool scene. Really excited.
Reality seem so hollow and broken. I know you feel the same. But they say Saturdays are made for rest. Settle down and let your heart win. So why am I a nervous wreck? Try to let myself enjoy this. I call for myself but I never hear back. My home and my future are under attack. But you can be honest and tell me you don't. Like me, so I can go out there myself and use my voice, make this better than fiction. gonna give it up. Even with 100,000 people saying this is all wrong, I don't know what you're on. And this is all just some strange fiction that you're dreaming up and getting lost in. Sometimes it opens up a vortex, sucks me in, and I'm falling to my early doom. When I think about my life too closely, passing judgment on my every move, I wish that I could take this slow. The world and others, the weight of existence returns. I know I just need something to help me see that this could be better than fiction.
That's a wrap.
Yeah.